Hi. Today we are going to see the logistics and supply chain management. I am Satish Jain, Assistant Professor, Bharat Institute of Law, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research, Chennai. Today we are going to see warehouse management. A warehouse is a commercial building for storage of goods. Warehouses are used by manufacturers, importers, exporters, wholesalers, transport businesses, customs, etc. The commercial building for the storage of goods for the manufacturer, importers, exporters, wholesalers, and transport businesses and customs, etc. For the they are usually large plain building in industrial areas of cities and towns and villages. They usually have loading docks to load and unload goods from trucks. Sometimes warehouses are designed for loading and unloading of goods directly from railways, airports, or seaports. The large plain building in industrial areas of cities and towns and villages, they have loading the docks to load and unload the goods from the trucks to transport the products from one place to another. Sometimes the warehouses are designed for loading and unloading the goods directly from the manufacturer or transportation like railways, airports, or seaports. They have cranes, forklifts for moving goods, which are usually placed on ISO standard pallets loaded into pallets racks. Storage goods can include any raw materials, packing materials, spare parts, components, or finished goods associated with agriculture, manufacturing, and production. The products of raw materials, finished goods, packing materials, or spare parts, finished goods associated with the agriculture units, manufacturing, and production. The warehouse management system, that is WMS, is a software application that supports the day-to-day operations in a warehouse. The warehouse management system software applications supports day-to-day operations in a warehouse management for enable the programs of centralized management of tasks such as tracking, inventory levels, and stock locations. To find the stocks and finished goods or raw materials where they kept in the warehouse, to find that particular inventory products from the software application supported by the operation to enable the products to find the location of the stocks where they kept from the identification. This study attempts to the study of performance of administrative and physical functions associated with storage of goods and materials. The functions associated with storage of goods and materials. These functions include the receipts, identification, inspection, verification, putting away the retrieval for issues. If the product is any issues, it will find out by the quantity and quality check. The warehouse management. The warehousing refers to the activities involving storage of goods on a large scale in a systematic and orderly manner, and making them available conveniently when needed. Means holding or preserving goods in huge quantities from the time of their purchase, or products which are production till their actual use or sales. The preserving goods in huge quantities to be maintained by customers when they buy or order the particular product for their use. The production till their actual use or sales. Creates a time utility by bridging the time gap between the production and consumption of goods. Meaning and definition. What is warehouse? Warehouse is a place where the goods are kept is called warehouse. Where the place goods are kept is called warehouse. Who is warehouse keeper? The person in charge of a warehouse is called warehouse keeper. The person in charge of warehouse is called warehouse keeper. A commercial building for storage of goods. It is a commercial building for storage of goods used by manufacturers, importers, exporters, wholesalers, transport business, and customers, etc. Need for warehouse. Need for warehousing. Warehousing is necessary due to the following reasons. That is seasonal production. First one, seasonal production. You know that agriculture commodities are harvested during the certain seasons, but their consumption or uses takes place throughout the year. Therefore, there is a need for proper storage or warehousing for their commodities, from where they can be supplied as the required form. The seasonal production, the agriculture products or commodities, harvesting the products from the particular season. Next, seasonal demand. Seasonal demand means there is a certain goods which are demanded seasonally, like woolen garments in winters or umbrellas in rainy seasons. These are the seasonal manufacturing or seasonal demand. Another one more example, AC, air conditioner. That also only the summer season is the demand, the seasonal demand. The production of these goods takes place throughout the year to be meet the seasonal demand. So there is a need to store these goods in a warehouse to make them available at time of the need. To store this particular product for the seasonal demand. So we need the store goods for the particular product. That is to be the goods is stored in a warehouse to make them available at the time of the need. Next, large scale production. In this case, the manufactured goods, nowadays the production takes place to meet the existing as well as future demand of the production. Manufacturers also produce goods in huge quantity to enjoy the benefits of large scale production, which is more economical. The manufacturer also produces goods in huge quantity to enjoy the benefits of large scale production, which is more economical. So the finished products which are produced on a large scale need to be stored properly till they are cleared by the sales. when the sales is or demand is actually stored for the particular large scale production. Next, quick supply. Both industrial as well as agriculture goods are produced at some specific places but consumed throughout the country. This is essential to stock these goods near the place of consumption so that without making any delay, these goods are made available to the consumers at the time of their need. The quick supply is both the industrial as well as the agriculture side. The goods are produced at some specific place but consumed through the country. Consumed throughout the country. Therefore, it is an essential need of the stock of the goods for near the place of consumption so that without making any delay, these goods are made available to the consumer at the time of their need. Next, continuous production. Continuous production of goods in factories requires adequate supply of raw materials. The raw materials, who send the raw materials to the manufacturer, is called supplier. The supplier who supply the raw materials is called supplier. That supplier sends the raw materials to the production plant for the continuous production. That is called the continuous production. So there is a need to keep sufficient quantity of stock of the raw materials in the warehouse to ensure the continuous production. Then only we make the continuous production. The raw materials will be always available in the warehouse. Then only we make the continuous production. Next, price stabilization. To maintain a reasonable level of price of the goods in the market, the maintain a reasonable level of price for the particular product or a particular goods of the market, there is a need to sufficient stock in the warehouses. Scarcity in supply of goods may increase their price in the market. Away excess production and supply may also lead to fall in prices of product by maintaining a balance of supply of goods. The products of maintaining a balance of supply for the goods. Warehousing leads to price stabilization. Next, warehouse activities. What are the activities to be working in warehouse? That is receiving goods, identify the goods, dispatch the goods to storage, hold goods, pick goods, marshal shipment, dispatch the shipment, operate an information system. First one, receive goods. The goods accepts from outside the transportation or attach the factory and accept the responsibility. Next, check the goods against an order and the billing of loading the particular product. When the loading to a transportation, we verify the billing and quantity and quality check. Check the quantities. Check for damage if, fill out the damage if necessary. Suppose a product is damaged, we will find out, the warehouse keeper or warehouse management will find out the damage, means the report will be made for the necessary. Inspect the goods if required. Inspect the goods when they are required. Verify the goods. The items are identified with the appropriate stock keeping unit, that is called SKU. stock keeping unit. The number of part numbers, the quantity and the serial number, the barcodes are recorded in the verifying the machineries to find out the stock keeping unit, the particular product where they keep the product from the warehouse, to identify the particular location where they kept the particular production of the product. Items are identified with the appropriate stock keeping unit, that is SKU. The number of part, the quantities received recorded. Patch goods to storage. Pack goods to storage. Goods are sorted by, put away or sorted out by the identification of the storage places. Next, hold goods. Goods are kept in storage under the proper protection until they need it. The goods were kept in the storage in warehouse to be maintained the production and the production under the proper product protection will be product there until they be needed. The product will be needed. Pick the goods. Items required from stock must be selected from storage and brought to a marshalling area. Items required from the stock must be selected from the particular area to be marshalling the area to load or unload the particular products from the warehouse. Marshal the shipment. The goods making up a single order are brought together and checked for omissions or errors. The goods making up a single order are brought together and checked for omissions or errors. If any problems mean to find the particular records and find that and updated the orders records are updated. And inward outward products which are in loaded and unloaded the particular area. Dispatch the shipment. Orders are packed, shipping documents are prepared and goods loaded on the vehicle. Operate an information system. A record must be maintained for each items in stock showing the quantity on hand. The stock showing the quantity of hand, quantity received, quantity issued, and location in the warehouse. That is the operation of information system. What are the types of warehouses? Private warehouse, public warehouse, government warehouse, cooperative warehouses, bonded warehouses, distribution centers or warehouses, cold storage, export and import, climate controlled field warehouses, agriculture warehouses. Warehouses types. Private warehouse. A private warehouse is a warehouse where is privately owned by wholesalers, distributors or manufacturers, large retail and online market places also have their own privately owned warehouses. The private manufacturer have their own warehouse, that is private warehouse. These are owned and managed by the channel suppliers, manufacturers or traders and resellers and are used exclusively for their own distribution activities. Own distribution activities. The person of traders or resellers to be owned or distribution activities. For example, for private warehouses, warehouses constructed by farmers or producers near their fields or place of the work. The warehouse owned and managed by wholesalers, retailers close to their selling centers to use the utilize the products to store the warehouse and selling the particular product to the customer. The warehouses constructed by manufacturers near their production units. Warehouses taken on rent by retail stores. Sometimes the warehouses are taken by rent by retail stores. The retailers may have several regional warehouses to cater the needs of their stores. The retailers have several regional warehouses to utilize the need of their storage places. The private warehouses owned and leased by the wholesaler where it stores and distributes. Maintaining by the private warehouses involves fixed as well as variable costs. Variable cost. For example, the fixed costs are basically the investment made in terms of insurance, capital, interest, and taxes. The variable cost, on the other hand, include maintenance cost and operation cost. The fixed costs are basically invested, made in terms of insurance, capital, interest, and tax. The variable of the cost from the hand includes the maintenance cost and operating costs. Therefore, due to the large expenses, private companies prefer to have assistance of public warehouses and will go for the private warehouses under following the situations. Number one, wide presence and the firm commitments in the region and necessity to have the permanent basis in an area. Considering the long-term strategy advantages. Third one, scope of optimum utilization is assured for long period. Fourth one, to build advantage over competitors. That's why they are prepared for private warehouses. These are the four things to manufacturers using the private warehouses. Next, public warehouses. These warehouses are owned by government and semi-government bodies and are made available to private firms to store goods on payment of rent. The public warehouses are usually set up to help small traders who are not in position to have their own warehouses due to their financial constraints. Therefore, in order to promote the trade and industry, the central or state government come forward to cater such storage needs of traders and retailers. Anyone can available these facilities to solve its short-term distribution needs. Retailers sometimes, due to increased sales, even their private warehouses for insufficient if their facilities have reached capacity, is the capacity, or if they are making a special or huge purchase of production for some reasons. That's why they are using the public warehouses. For example, for public warehouses, before the festivals or before marriages seasons, the retailers may order extra machines to avoid the out of stock situations. That is the main reason for the before festivals and before marriages, the retailers may order the extra products for their out of stock situations. These warehouses are typically regulated by the government bodies. The cost incurred by the private firms for the use of public warehouses are considered as variable. These warehouses are mainly used by manufacturers, producers, exporters, and importers. Next, bonded warehouses. These warehouses are owned, managed, and controlled by government as well as private agencies. The bonded warehouses are stored facilities used to store imported goods for the import duties is still to be paid. The store imported goods for the which the import duties is still to be paid. The bonded warehouses run by private agencies have to be obtained license from the government. The private agency to be obtained license from the government. In actual, this enables the government bodies to hold control on private firms to pay their taxes on time. Without paying duties, importers cannot take over or open their goods. Globally, it has been seen that these warehouses are found near the ports and are usually owned by dock authorities. Bonded warehouses are subject to types of taxes, excise duty and custom duty. These are the bonded warehouse. Next, cooperative warehouses. As the very name implies, these warehouses are owned, managed, and controlled by cooperative societies. These societies provide storage facilities on the most economical rate to their members only. The basic purpose to run such a warehouses is not to earn profit, but to help the members for the cooperative societies. Next, distribution centers or warehouses. This type of storage facility usually have large space, which enables fast movement of large quantities of storages for short period. While on the other hand, conventional warehouses hold goods for long time, say 2 months or 3 months or 6 months or 1 year. These warehouses basically by nature serve as points in the distribution systems at which the goods are procured from the different suppliers and quickly transferred to various customers. These customers provide computerized control which may movement of goods fast and reliable. The distribution centers, the warehouse, they make for the products to be located and easily to transport or sell the particular product quick and fast and reliable. That is the main reason for the distribution centers. In order to minimize the delivery time, these storage facilities are found close to transportation centers. In some cases, distribution centers handle the goods for less than a day period, such as in case of fast foods or purchasable products. Most of the goods enter in the early morning, dawn time, and is transferred, distributed by the evening time. Government warehouses. The government warehouses are owned, managed, and governed by central or state government. They can be used by both private companies and government agencies for storage of goods. They are therefore also considered as a form of public warehouse also owned by government. The government warehouse also owned by government, and public warehouses also governed by central or state government. Next, cold storage warehouse. In simple words, a cold storage warehouse is an area or a building restricted to certain environmental condition to keep the product safe. These warehouses usually look like any other warehouses from other side, but differ in their inner environment. But the outside differ in their inner environment. A cold storage warehouse undoubtedly differs from any other kind of warehouses as per its name itself. Unlike other warehouses, a cold storage warehouse requires extra maintenance and surveillances in terms of temperature and heat exchange. That is the main thing for the cold storage warehouse. Next, production that can be get damaged on normal room temperature. The products that can be damaged at the normal room temperature. The condition need a cold storage for the safe storage. To get a clear understanding of how it works, let's have a look at the type of these storages. For example, the food products, milk products. Everything that you buy from the market and store in your refrigerator definitely would have come from a cold storage warehouse. We store the product into the refrigerator. That food products are such as dairy products, meat, vegetables, ice creams, etc. are required the cold warehouse storage. The dairy products, meat, vegetables, ice creams, etc. are requires the cold warehouse storage to preserve the particular products. Next, import and export. The international trade of a country which other countries is referred to as import and export. The word import refers to international trade, where a country buys goods and service from another country. Whereas the word export refers to the international trade where a country sells goods and services to other countries, that is export. Climate control. If your unit is climate control, the term climate control for the purpose of this lease means that the facility will be use reasonable efforts to avoid the temperature extremes in a unit by keeping the unit warmer than the outside temperature. In the cold weather and cooler than the outside temperature in hot weather. Field warehouse. Field warehouse is a terminology used for a building which has been rented and it is being used by one company, where this building lies on the property owned by the owner of the building. A leasing agreement is agreed upon between the two parties in this agreement. Agricultural warehouses. To run warehouses for the storage of agriculture produce, seeds, fertilizers, and notified commodities for individuals, cooperatives, and other institutions. To act as an agent of government for the purchase, sale, storage, and distribution of the above commodities using the agricultural warehouses. reordering level of stock. It is also known as ordering levels or ordering points or ordering limit. It is a point at which the order for supply of the material should be made. This level is fixed somewhere between the maximum level and the minimum level in such a way that the quantity of materials represented by the difference between the reordering level and the minimum level will be sufficient to the meet of demands of the production till such a time as the materials are replaced. Reorder level depends mainly on the maximum rate of the consumption and order lead timing. When this level is reached, the storage keeper will initiate the purchase requisition. Distribution requirement planning. Distribution requirements planning is the method used by supply chain entity to plan orders in the whole supply chain, taking into account that is inventories to be kept along with buffer or safety stock. Placing the orders with the manufacturer to replenish inventories to meet customers' orders, etc. It is similar to materials requirement planning, that is material requirement planning, MRP. Expect that MRP is used in manufacturing companies and DRP is used for logistics companies. DRP means distribution requirement planning. Codification. The process of codification or cataloging involves namely classifying, describing the items or an assignment. The assignment of the system aids logistics process to include the supply, purchasing, maintenance, warehousing, transportation, planning, etc. The system logistics process to include supply, purchasing, maintenance, warehousing, transportation, planning, etc. Further, it also different organizations to even countries to cooperate in providing logistics support to military, disaster relief, peacekeeping, and similar operations. Thank you.